I hope you all are doing good. So before proceeding further, I would like to tell you that Project Vedna is an initiative undertaken by SarkariSchool.in, an initiative by the non-profit organization We Citizens Foundation that focuses on menstruation, its awareness, and to discourage girls' absenteeism in school during those days. So as we all know that Menstrual Hygiene Day is an annual awareness day which is celebrated today, that is on May 28th, to highlight the importance of good menstrual hygiene management at a global level. So why to shy? Be period proud and let's talk about it.
Menstrual hygiene basically refers to the availability of products like sanitary napkins, menstrual cups, or tampons which absorb the flow of blood when a woman is menstruating. It also means the access to proper washroom facilities, clean water, soap, facilities to dispose of used menstrual management materials, and other things which help women to manage their periods in a hygienic and a healthy way.
We should know that during menstruation, it is important to stay hygienic, but should also know that not only we should stay hygienic on those 7 days of period, but it should be practiced whole month. 1 in 3 girls face inadequate sanitization and many other face social and cultural limits during their periods. Access to safe sanitization is extremely important for women and girls during their menstrual cycle. Nearly 23 million girls drop out of schools annually due to lack of proper menstrual hygiene facilities. Sanitization facility is close proximity provides a considerable level of comfort for girls who suffer from severe menstrual cramping. In India, there are still many places where toilets are not available, which is the major problem. So we should ensure that a female gets enough privacy in order to clean up properly and maintain a better hygiene.
Hello everyone. So today I'll be sharing with you a few tips on hygiene that you should be keeping in mind while you're menstruating. Firstly, one should take a clean shower each day, irrespective of whether you're menstruating or not. And why I say this is because I'm sure most of us while growing up have been advised to avoid showers during periods, which is bountifully wrong. We should bathe ourselves and stay clean, right? Secondly, I'm sure you change your pads or tampons frequently. If not, consider doing so. Otherwise, you may be exposed to rashes, itching, and various skin infections.
Hello everyone. Today, I'll be telling you about the hygienic methods of using the menstrual products. Number one is the sanitary pad. You have to change your sanitary pad every 6 to 8 hours, even if you have low flow or medium flow. For high flow people, you can change it every 6 hours, or those who have low flow or medium flow, they should change it every 8 hours. Secondly is tampon. Always wash your hands before using a tampon so that no germs are transferred from the hand to the tampon, and then insert it. Thirdly is the menstrual cup. Whenever you use a menstrual cup, boil it in hot water and keep it there for 15 minutes and then use it. And once you are done using it, again boil it and then store it.
During these times, we need to take care of the disposal as well, because disposing remains a pertinent problem in the rural areas. We need to dispose the menstruation products properly, and also we need to keep in mind that synthetic products or soaps should not be used during this period of time, as it causes a lot of other health problems. And lastly, we need to keep in mind that during menstruation, we need to stick to one method of sanitation and we need to follow it clearly.
I'm going to talk about disposal of used sanitary products. Number one, at home, try to segregate menstrual waste from domestic waste. Number two, in schools and colleges, suitable methods of sanitary disposal like incinerators should be made available, and menstrual education and awareness should be imparted to children.
Do not flush your sanitary napkins. The pads are made up of plastic polymers and can clog the pipes, which can lead to an overflow. The second is do not dispose of pads in the open, and the third is do not dispose of pads without properly wrapping them.
Here are a few things that you need to avoid during your period. Do not skip meals. Do not be a slave to your workout schedule. Do not eat too much greasy and oily food. Do not leave sanitary products in for too long. Do not get your breasts checked. Do not sleep with your tampon in.